Your Excellencies, the First Ladies, Ministers of Gender and Women Affairs from across Africa, distinguished guests and participants, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed, I'm the Minister of Gender, Children, Disability, Elderly, Social Affairs and Community Development in Malawi. I'm a PhD holder in the Development Studies. I'm also having a Master's in Counseling and Guidance, a degree in Finance and Investment Analysis. I'm a teacher by profession. I'm a seasoned politician. I joined politics in 1999 up to now. And I'm sure some of these things, they were good to ask our CVs before we start the meeting, so that you got to know us, who we are, than even introducing ourselves. But still, I'm your sister. We thank the president for the appointment of this meeting. It is a great privilege and honor for me and also the Malawi delegation to be part of the 7th edition of Merck Foundation Africa Asia Alumni 2021. Am I there? Hello?
Yes, Excellency, we hear you very well, loud and clear.
Oh, very good, very good. I'm grateful to Her Excellency, the First Lady, Madam Esther Lungu, the First Lady of the Republic of Zambia, for co-chairing this important summit. The conference comes at a time when our countries are struggling to manage the gendered impact of COVID-19. The pandemic has disrupted the social, economic, and also political life. The situation is even far much worse for women and girls. The hardship includes increased work burden resulting from unpaid work, job losses, caring for the sick, the elderly, and also the orphaned. Your Excellencies, the level of gender-based violence have also increased. The closure of schools has expected child marriages and also teen pregnancies. The assessment of teen pregnancies and child marriages has took place in August, from August and September 2020. I found that from February to the time of the assessment, 44,872 teen pregnancies and also 12,995 child marriages has been recorded. And this is the whole reason why we had also a meeting of call to action of members of civil society organizations, the directors, and also our partners, donors, IMF, to make sure that we come to an end of these child marriages, which is really going to make us not to reach the United Nations agenda of 2030 and also the African Union agenda of 2063. We have our own vision as well as Malawi government, the vision 2063 of the number of programs, 7 of those and 3 programs which we need to tackle. Your Excellencies, we all know that achieving gender equality and also the empowerment of women will facilitate the demographic dividends and also sustainable economic growth. It is a concern to note that despite Africa realizing economic growth of above 4%, 600 million people still live on less than $2 per day. Malawi experienced economic growth during the mid-2000s, even though its effects on poverty was minimal. The poverty situation analysis level, that 50.7% of the population are poor and 70% of that are women. In this regard, the government of Malawi, under His Excellency the State President of the Lazarus, has set a priority of both growth and also poverty reduction while addressing the economic slowdown. Accelerated economic growth is needed to reduce inequalities and also poverty to improve people's lives. And that's the call for coordination that we need to fight a number of challenges which we have, even calling upon the women themselves to take part. And even the girls themselves, if you want to end the child marriages or the teen pregnancies, that they've got to know the importance of being participating in a number of programs according to the country's level, i.e. Malawi. Malawi, just like other countries, can achieve accelerated economic growth by making strategies, strategic investments in gender equality, health, education, and as well as building on existing policies which create jobs. The health programs should also meet the demand for family planning services at all the levels, currently at 46%, while implementing the compulsory education and intensifying the integrated early childhood development as a stepping stone for the early school enrollment and also cooperation. This is just to thank the first lady for co-chairing, but also some government ministers and directors for this function. This is a very important meeting that we need to be coordinating, we need to be discussing and see the way forward, how we are to bail out our countries and Africa at large. The challenges for girls and women are so paramount, and also the importance of economic empowerment and also the girl education is also so paramount. We are calling upon and even saluting all our partners who are supporting us and make sure that we move together. And as we are looking forward for the African Union and also the United Nations, as well as also our own vision and also our policies as a government, we thank our first ladies and we thank our leadership for guiding us and also for supporting us. They have the passion of the women and girls at heart, and we are looking forward for the issues to move forward as we look into their long leave as well as their program to be implemented. We thank you very much, the leadership of this fora, so that we need to work together and we will continuously supporting you. Thanks so much and God bless you.